Recently, Steve Sapel responded to our basic cholesterol 101. Had a lot of questions. One of the key ones, though, is interesting discussion, Dr. Brewer. Most people know or have heard the terms LDL and HDL, but what are the real differences between these low and high density lipoproteins? I've done some videos on the differences between LDL and HDL. I'll sort of skim through that and then get into ApoA1 and ApoB. You see, ApoA1 is the proteins that you find in HDL. ApoB is the protein that you find in LDL, VLDL, ILDL, and chylomicrons. I threw out a lot of names there. Let's go back and simplify. HDL just stands for high-density lipoprotein. Why is it higher density than LDL, which is low-density lipoprotein, and for sure higher density than VLDL, which is very low-density lipoprotein? By the way, IDL is intermediate-density lipoprotein. It's density between LDL and VLDL, very low density. So why do we separate the cholesterol families and values out that way? Well, here's why. We can. Because we can, we start measuring it and looking at it. And what we've found is that these HDLs, as they increase in the blood testing, the patient tends to be healthier with less heart attack experience and less plaque. In fact, you may have seen from the Framingham studies that HDL appears to be far more important and far more helpful than LDL is in terms of danger. This fractionation demonstration also, it includes the VLDL that I mentioned, the LDL, HDL, chylomicrons that I mentioned, which are huge, big fluffy items that are full of cholesterol, and this SDLDL, which is small dense LDLs, those are the dangerous ones. And LP little a, I've got several videos on LP little a. It's a genetic variation of LDL, and it's got those Kringle repeats forming a little hook that we think may cause some of the problems. Now, we used to say that small dense LDL was the most dangerous because it could slip through injured or around injured intimal cells. Recent research shows that oxidized small dense LDL actually is transported through that intima layer. So again, a little bit of a change didn't change the vast majority of what we know, but again, creates some more opportunity on understanding this. Just briefly, I've shown this a couple of times in different cholesterol test videos. This is that LP little a, which this is Brad Bales. Brad has a cartoonist somewhere in his family and got the cartoonist to do this video. The point, or this image, the point behind this image is this skinny guy, LDL, bad cholesterol, saying, why do I get all the attention? And his point here is a good one. His point is that, you know, there's some other guys out there that are a bigger risk, like especially LP little a and small dense LDL. Covered a couple of items and helped put us into perspective in terms of looking at the lipoproteins. One other quick point, what is a lipoprotein? I've covered this in case you haven't seen my other videos, just a quick reminder. Lipoproteins are proteins that are used to form microscopic particles. So when we eat a salad that has olive oil dressing, or a hamburger that has fats in it, or avocado oil, or any type of animal or plant fat, that those fats and oils don't form a big glob in our blood, which is over 95% water. Everybody knows oil and water don't mix. And what happens if you have big globs like this? The medical term for a big glob is an embolus. And an embolus can, it gets stuck in the artery and cuts off blood supply. That happens with like high-speed wrecks where you get multiple bones broken, or it can happen with surgery as well, which is also just a type of trauma. So again, the body makes these proteins, and these proteins form microscopic pockets. This is the protein shell, a cholesterol ester shell, and the protein that helps form that shell. The fats or oils are inside that packet. Same thing with HDL. Now, what's the difference? As usual, I have to apologize for my visuals. This was a great picture, but it's not that high resolution. But the point here is there are different proteins for the HDL and LDL components. HDL has it's higher density for two reasons. Number one, it's got less fat, and number two, it's got higher protein concentration. So that's why HDL is measured as higher density. And that's also why these are both called, all of these populations are called lipo, which means fat or oil, proteins, which means protein. They're packets that are made up by the body's protein, which is made to encapsulate microscopic amounts of fats and oils that are transferred by the blood. Now, what does APO mean? Well, let's go back first and let's show this. You may notice, here's the point, APOA1, all of the quote good cholesterol or the HDL family is made up of one type of protein. The LDL families and the other, quote, bad cholesterol families are made up of ApoB. So there are tests, laboratory tests, which will show the difference between ApoA and ApoB. Again, what does ApoB mean? Let's break down this. This is a big word. Again, like many other medical and Latin root words, you just get one component of a word added to another, a suffix and another prefix and another suffix. ApoB means from or related to or completing or part of. Lipo means fat or oil, and protein, we all know what that means. Lipos, fats, oils, cholesterols, triglycerides, fatty acids, protein, we know what protein means. So an apolipoprotein is a protein that allows our blood to transport fats and oils safely. It is the protein part of a lipoprotein. So if you go back to this image, Take away the rest of the lipid part and leave the protein alone. That's apolipoprotein. Same thing here under the ADL. Take away all of the cholesterol, lipids, fats, and oils, and just leave the protein itself, and you get apolipoprotein B. As we said, apolipoprotein B is used in VLDL, the very low density lipoproteins, intermittent density lipoproteins, low-density lipoproteins, and chylomicrons. Apolipoprotein A is used in HDL, quote, the good cholesterol. ApoA1 is found in HDL particles. It's cardioprotective. It helps clear cholesterol away from arteries, that reverse transportation that you may have heard of. It's protective of dementia as well. So ApoA1, melano, is something that was discovered. They found that people that had a certain type of ApoA1 in this area of Italy, actually very near Milan, turned out to live to 80 to 100 years. They traced it back to an individual near Milan a couple of hundred years ago. His name was Giovanni Pomarelli, and his descendants, people that traced back to him, tend to have a very long lifestyle. I mean, a very long life. Given the fact that we're talking about HDL here, again, hopefully it helps you understand that HDL is very important to longevity. Now, there are people that have another variation of ApoA1. It's called E164X. They have big increases in premature cardiovascular disease. If you take people that are E164X of the ApoA1, version of the ApoA1, they have a significant plaque in all their arteries in their mid-30s, mid-40s. So again, significant thing to know about. You can also look at the ApoB over ApoA1 ratio. That doesn't require fasting. It's not affected by triglyceride levels. A high ratio may occur with a normal LDL, but demonstrate previously unrecognized risk. Moderate risk on ApoB over ApoA1 for men is 0.7 to 0.9, and for women it's 0.6 to 0.8. Here's the ranges for those numbers. So I hope this has been helpful. Basically, what we looked at was a little bit deeper version of apolipoproteins. I don't think that I covered what the labs look like. That's the simple part. You get labs and they'll show apolipoprotein A1. And apolipoprotein B. And most of the labs that I get will also show lipoprotein A, but you usually have to order that. If you've made it this far, Thank you for your interest. We're going to have an event, PrevMed Only, Heart Attack, Stroke, and Prevention Conference. It's November 8th and 9th at the University of Louisville Conference Center. Hope to see you there.